For example, the third, the style C that we have just seen, occurs in some variations in other monuments in other regions of the Islamic world. It can be found here combined with a geometrical star pattern in the ruins of Kharab Sayyar in northern Syria, or actually northern Mesopotamia, but present-day state of Syria. And where you can see these flowing lines of motifs in which one leaf is intimately connected with the other. Or in the mosque in Toulon in Cairo, erected nearly at the same time as the monuments of Samarra, where we find nearly the same elements. And we can also see the close link between the stucco and the woodwork, which we find from Samarra as well as from Ibn Tulun in Egypt, where the same kind of, the same treatment of forms can be seen in the carved wood. And this is also one of the characteristic properties of stucco work through all periods of Islamic art, that there is a close connection between stucco and other media of art, and we find the same forms and the same stylistic development in different materials. So, while the beveled style, as we have just seen, somehow radiated from the capital region and was copied in some other provinces, the other styles that we have seen in Samarra, particularly style A, were already current in some regions of the Caliphate during the early Abbasid period. So their story reaches further back than the Samarra period, further back than the 9th century. Here is one example from Raqqa, from the palaces from the period of Harun al-Rashid, around 800 AD, in which we can see the vine leaves, the five-petaled leaves, in a very similar shape as we have just seen them in Samarra, while other leaves are more elongated, but the whole treatment of forms is similar to what we have just seen, and you will also note the rows of pierced beads that accompany the bands of the vegetal ornament here. Very similar in motifs and in the forms in which the motifs are rendered. We find this in other Abbasid period buildings, early Abbasid period buildings, for example, on the Hajj route through Saudi Arabia from Iraq to Mecca. But we also find them at earlier periods in monuments of which it is difficult to tell whether they were still Sasanian or already early Islamic. For example, here at Tepe Hisar in northern Iran, from Tepe Hisar we have this stucco panel that is now in the National Museum in Tehran, and please forgive me the reflections of the on the glass in the photograph, but I think what it's possible to recognize that we do have similar arrangements of tendrils and leaves, and also the beads in the accompanying bands here, as we have them in the Raqqa and Samarra stucco. And we find a very similar treatment of forms in the stucco from the region of the Sasanian capital of Ctesiphon, where the excavations of the residential area of Salman Park has also rendered stucco fragments that originally belonged to the wall decoration of residential houses and that are now kept in the Islamic Museum in Berlin. Again, either late Sasanian or early Islamic, and with a very similar set of forms. So we can see that there was a kind of common language of stucco in the regions of Iraq and Iran that belonged to the Sasanian empire and that were later inherited by Islamic culture, and that this way became part of early Islamic art or the art of architectural decoration in the early Islamic period. The traces of this development can be seen as far as the 10th century, for example, in the famous Mosque of Na'in in central Iran, where parts of the stucco decoration of the original building have been preserved. In the mihrab area, with these stout columns that bear decorations of vine leaves and tendrils encased in these geometric frames, and under the arches, where we have other arrangements that appear like a free variation of Samarra style B, rather than style A that we find in some variation here on the columns. The most famous piece of the stucco decoration in Na'in is the mihrab, and here we can see